After you've installed Anki on your computer, you can download shared decks by opening the program and then going down to the bottom left button here, Get Shared, and clicking on it. When we click on it, it will take us to a list of shared decks in your web browser. Over here we can see some popular categories, so if we click on Japanese for example, it will show us a list of all the Japanese related decks that have been uploaded. So as a little sample today, let's study some state capitals. So I'll go to the geography section, or I could type in a search here instead. And we've got some different choices here. I'm going to choose a simple one, which has just 50 state capitals and no audio and no images. So to download this and put it into Anki, all I have to do is click Info and then go down here and click the download button. And you can see above here we have a preview of the content that will appear when we study. And this particular deck is quite simple, but if we look at other decks here, we've got ones with images, some of them will include sounds, and so on. So let's go back to the state capitals and click download. And we'll save it to our computer. And once it's downloaded, all we have to do is double click on it, and it should automatically be loaded into Anki. 50 cards imported, okay. So we close this, and we can see that a deck has appeared here, and it's telling us that we have 20 new cards to study today. By default, Anki will introduce 20 cards per day, so that you don't get overrun with reviews in the future. You can customize this number if you'd like to. So let's click on this deck, and we're presented with an overview screen here. And you can see here that it tells us we've got 20 new cards, and we've got 0 learning and review cards. So let's just jump into studying for now. We click the Study Now button, and we're presented with a question here. We're studying state capitals here, so I have to think of the capital city of Alabama. And I believe the answer is Montgomery. So once I've thought about the answer and I've decided, okay, I know this, and I've said it to myself, I go down here and I click the Show Answer button to see if I'm correct or not. And you'll see that you can also press the space bar on your keyboard if you want to do that. So I'll click for now, and we can see that the answer is Montgomery, so I was correct. Now I have 3 choices down the bottom, again, good, and easy. If I forgot, or if I didn't know the answer to this card, I would click again, and the card would be shown to me again in less than a minute, so that I am reminded quickly and I have a chance to actually learn this and remember it. If I did know the answer, but I'd like to test myself again in a little while, I can click Good, and the card will be shown to me again within 10 minutes, depending on how many other cards you have to study. And if I thought, oh, this is easy, I don't need to review this again for a while, I can click Easy, and it will be shown to me again in 4 days. So I think I remembered this reasonably well, but I'd like to practice again in 10 minutes, so I will press the Good button. And again, if you hover over, you can see there's a shortcut key, 1, 2, 3. So I'll click on Good here. Okay, Alaska, I think, was Juno. Let's show the answer. I'll press the space bar this time. Juno, okay, I was correct. And again, I'd like to practice again in 10 minutes, so I will choose Good here. I can either press number 2, or I can also press the space key. You can see that this button has actually got a little blue border indicating that this is the default answer. This is the answer that Anki is recommending you choose if you knew it. So I'll just press the space bar again. Okay, Arizona, I don't remember the answer to this one, so I'm going to just click Show Answer, and I find out that the answer is Phoenix. Okay, in this case, because I didn't know it, I'm going to choose Again instead of Good. And when I do that, Anki will show it to us again in 1 minute, and then if we get it right 1 minute later, then we'll see it again in 10 minutes. So we're making 2 steps, a 1 minute step, then a 10 minute step. So if I choose Again, you notice that the count has gone to 4. Previously it was 2. So half of that count is that card we forgot. Okay, let's do a couple more. Arkansas, I don't remember this one either, so let's show the answer. Little Rock. Okay, so I'm going to choose again, but this time I'll use my keyboard. I'll press 1, which is a shortcut for again. And Arizona. Here's our... Notice that the number here is underlined. That little underline indicates that the currently displayed card is a learning card rather than a new card or a review card. So this Arizona one we answered a couple of minutes ago, and we're now being asked on it again. So I think it was Phoenix. Let's give this a try. Yes, I was correct. Okay, so this time I did remember, so I'm going to choose good rather than again. California is Sacramento. Okay, good. And you can continue like this until your cards, the count down the bottom reaches 0. You don't have to study until 0 if you don't have time. If you'd like to stop, you can simply close the program or click decks to return to the list of decks here. And one other thing to note is that by default we have a limit of 20 new cards and a limit of 100 reviews, so that if you go on a holiday or something, you're not confronted with a huge list of cards to review again. If you want to change these limits, all you need to do is click the options button, and then you can configure number of new cards per day, for example, the amount of delay between when you forget a card, which is 1 minute, and the next step, which is 10. You can give yourself more steps if you want to. You can have steps of hours. Well, that's totally configurable. And in the review section, you can configure the maximum reviews a day. One other thing I should point out, if you look at the top of this screen, there's an options group section. And by default, all of the decks that you import or add will share the same set of options, so that when you change the options, the options will change for every deck. If you'd like to have some decks with different options, for example, if you'd like to study more German cards than you are studying your computing cards, on the top right you can click that button, and it will allow you to create a new option group, and then you can tell each deck which option group you want to use.